What if I told you there was a way to have announcements update automatically in the announcements layer? Well, stick around and I'll show you how. Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to use smart playlists in the announcement layer to have announcement slides update automatically. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever wanted to kind of automate things so that you don't have to just manually go in and add new slides in the announcement layer every single week or remove old ones, all that stuff, go ahead. Like, subscribe, share this with a friend. So this was something that someone asked about in the official ProPresenter users community that I run on Facebook along with Renewed Vision, who wrote ProPresenter. And they, when someone asked that, the response was, "Nah, you can't do that." Well, can you? The answer is, yeah, you can. You just have to know a little something. In fact, it's one of the joys of my life. Anytime I find someone that is an expert in ProPresenter and I can teach them something, because there's so much to know that it's a joy to me when someone teaches me something. So just enjoying the give and take of that. And there was someone that I considered an expert, and I helped him learn a little something about ProPresenter with this. So let's head over and let me show you what I'm talking about. So this uses a couple of different things inside of ProPresenter. So let's first go into the setting that we need to change to make this happen. And I'm going to do this with just a couple of announcement slides, but you'll see that once I get this all set up, I could add any number and remove any number at any time. So let's first go up to ProPresenter and settings, and then from inside settings, let's go to import. I think it's import. Yes, it is. Okay, so these are going to be images, and I want them to be foreground images, so that if you click on them and then move on to something else, you don't have a problem. So that's what you want. And then let's do a time, and 6 seconds is fine. I could also do 7, probably wouldn't want to do less than 5, but whatever. Just set the appropriate time and the behavior here. You can either have it go to next or go to random. Doesn't matter which you prefer. I'm going to leave it at next just so that it'll be more linear and obvious. So that's the first thing we need to change. You can change that manually, but I just, when it's set to do that automatically, that's going to make a lot of this easier. Now down here, I'm going to collapse Pro Content there, where it says playlists. This is actually a little hint of how I'm going to do this. If I click on the little plus button and select new smart playlist, notice it doesn't say folder, it says playlist. So I click on that, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to navigate to a folder that has announcement slides in it. So let's see here. Oh yeah, announcements. Let's make sure that, yeah, I do have 3 in there. So that's the ones that I'm going to get. These are 3 that Church Motion Graphics let me use. So if you like what you see there, then we'll use that. These are kind of generic, wrong time of year for when I'm recording it, but that doesn't matter really. What matters is when I click OK, we have this smart playlist. Now, notice I already had this up here, but it's called announcements and it's got this little icon. So with it set up like this, notice we've got a 7-second timer on each one of these, and they're set to go to the next one like this. So what I can do now is create a new presentation. So I'm going to go little plus button next to the word library, new presentation. I could have also done command in on a Mac or control in on Windows. Would have done the exact same thing. Select that, and let's just call this automatic announcements. And the theme doesn't matter in this case because these are just images, so we don't have to worry about the text or anything. And then size, I'm going to want the resolution of my largest screen that these are going to go up on. Bring it into the appropriate library. If I had an announcement library, maybe I'd want to do that. But really, you probably wouldn't use in this trick because it's going to be down here. Bring that into whichever playlist you want to be in. I have a generic playlist called Playlist. Very inventive, I admit. And now we just click New. Okay, now we've got this. So you might think, oh yeah, you just put each of these in here. No, no, no. Remember, these are playlists. So I can grab the entire playlist and drop it right there. Okay? I can decide if I wanted to always re-trigger every time you click on it. And I also need to put it on the announcement layer. I told you about that. So I'm going to click on here and this little target and change it to announcements. And so now, even though it doesn't look like it's doing anything, it would send it out to the announcement layer. Unfortunately, I'm using the announcement layer for this. So I'm going to change this back just to demonstrate this to you. It will do the exact same thing. But when I click on it, notice it has selected this first one. And after 7 seconds, I expect it goes on to the next one. And then another 7 seconds, it goes on to this third one, just to show you I'm not clicking. And then we'll see what happens. When that 7 seconds ends, it starts all over. But what's automatic about this? Well, let's go into Finder here. That's actually on another one of my screens here. So that's in Mac OS, and I'm going to click Command N here. And now let's go down and let's find that particular playlist, which is, or folder, which is this guy right here. And I'm going to pull out 3, which is the one that's up there right now, and just put it somewhere else. So for whatever reason, that didn't want to do what I wanted it to do. So let's just drag it. And oh, come on. Let's do this a different way. So let's do this. And that way I can just drag it from over here, over into here. And that should. Or let's just temporarily move it to the trash. Whatever. So move to trash. There we go. Okay, now notice that when I move that to the trash, now I only have these two. Well, what if I want to add something else back in? I'm going to go back here to where it was in the trash and just drag it and drop it back into the announcements, and it's back. So that is the power of the smart playlists, is that ProPresenter is always monitoring them. So you could have that as a shared location, maybe a place where you can airdrop to, whatever. You probably would not want that to be a cloud drive location. In fact, this actually just bit me in one of my in-person classes, because you'll notice I've got this little cloud icon here. This is actually in Dropbox. And when I got home, I fixed this. I had a problem with the Wi-Fi connecting to my computer, and these three were not showing up at all because Dropbox did me a good favor and deleted the local copy. So what I did was I changed it so that it would stay resident here. So you would probably not want it to be a Dropbox folder, but as long as you can get it in there, then it will update automatically. And all you have to do is every week, the automatic announcements one is the one that you update just on the storage drive of your computer, and then go from there. By the way, this playlist, not necessarily the smart playlist, but just playlists in general, using this trick is a great way to do slideshows. So if someone has a wedding or a funeral or pictures from VBS or a vacation Bible school, for those that aren't familiar, which is like a kids camp, or like a missions trip, some sort of event where they just give you a bunch of pictures, you can import them all into a playlist with those import settings that I showed you, and then just drag and drop that whole shebang there, and it will play just like this. So if instead of as foregrounds, you had them set as backgrounds, then they'd be persistent through an entire song, for example. So that's a powerful thing that not a lot of people use inside of ProPresenter. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/proquick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.